the revolution's over, we're going to have to start our own democracy.
A history lesson on voting in America could put a kid to sleep, but when Benjamin Franklin tells it,
I thought it was educational and fun.
Alina Pulley's a fifth grader at City View Community. The actors are from the National Theater for Children. They went around to 10 Twin Cities schools ahead of Election Day.
Trying to get them started young and teach them about how they can vote and what they can vote for.
And so, in between costume changes, they explain the key terms.
Voting takes place at a polling place.
So what I didn't know was that you can do it like in churches and schools.
There's even a character on a mission to prevent people from voting.
And voting is useless.
Second grade teacher Faye Wooten says learning styles vary from kid to kid. For some, classrooms and textbooks are enough. For others,
I'm right for mayor.
This helps.
We were learning about government this year in our reading curriculum. I'm glad they had some background before attending the program.
And there's a good chance her students will bring this lesson back to the classroom.
Oh yes, they're gonna say let's vote for a game, and they're probably gonna vote on their snacks.
No more ice cream!
Kaya Edwards, KARE 11 Sunrise.
Pretty cool. The National Theater for Children is based in the Twin Cities and performances are free. If you'd like to schedule a play at your school, request a reservation online. We have the link on our site, KARE11.com/sunrise.